good and healthy. Lots of innocent people suffering down there in Houston. Good Christians, good churches. Brother Joel Osteen, he said, and I saw the pictures, the bottom floor of his church was flooded. Amen. They was criticizing because they said, he's not taking care of the hurt. And people, you know, and he says, our staff can't even get out of their own home. They're pretty of their health having the flood. Amen. So you can find fault with me if you wanted to, if you look hard enough. I can find fault maybe with all of you. It would be hard because I love y'all and love you to see me. Amen. Amen. Praise God. This is why we got to love one another. Hold up to one another. Fight for one another. I got to cover your back. You got to cover my back. Because we love each other.
Amen.
We're family in this church.
Yes.
Come on. Amen. Praise God. So, pray. I've been praying for the pastor, not just in Houston, but in Miami and all the other places. Pray for him. Pray for him. I pray for the people and their buildings, because the devil hates churches. He'll try to tear them up if he can.
Mm-hmm.
So, just like this Hurricane Irma, you know, that's why we need to pray for God's people, because the devil will do his best when he's having his heyday, which is what these hurricanes are. The devil doing his thing. Amen. We need to pray that God will cover God's people, cover them, protect them. Praise God. Was that you testified that, what was this relation with this brother, your nephew? He went to Tennessee. Listen, some of y'all didn't hear this other night.
And my dad had to be worried about the house, so God take care of me. And go 2 weeks to come back, and mother called him and said, your house is there. So the street behind the street would probably be flooded, but no water came out of
her. Woo! Y'all hear that? The house across the street was flooded, houses behind him was flooded, but it didn't touch his house.
And he came here and he can't talk, but he's been church all the night, and he put in God's hand and we're saved. He didn't worry about it.
He totally trusted God. The bottom line to all of this is trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. Put your trust in the Lord. You don't have to worry about storms. You don't have to worry about your kinfolk. Just put them in God's hands. Pray over them. Yes, pray. Amen. But then leave them there. The old song says, take your burdens to the Lord and
leave them there.
If you trust and never doubt, He will always
bring you out.
Take your burdens to the Lord and leave them right there. Hallelujah. See, worry. The devil wants every one of us to get back in that old groove of worry. Fear. I'm afraid. What's going to happen to me? What am I going to be able to pay my bills? Yes! If you trust the Lord, He will make a way. You may not figure out how He's going to do it, but if you trust Him, He will work it out.
Amen. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes, He will.
Hallelujah. The weapons of our warfare are not carnal, not physical. Amen. Not flesh and blood, but they're mighty before God to the overthrow, the destruction of strongholds. Praise God. Praise God. Against the true knowledge of God, and we lead every thought, and bring the Amplified, and purpose away captive into the obedience of Christ, the Messiah, the Anointed One. That's 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verses 4 and 5. As a man thinketh in his heart,
so is he.
Be careful, careful, careful what you think. Praise God. God gave me a revelation just 2 or 3 days ago. And most of you don't know Brother Prophet Brady. And I just come to the point, and God just put this prayer in my heart and spirit and put this question. I said, God, this is the middle of the night. I'm 2 or 3 when the Lord usually speaks the strongest. He speaks another time during the day. But I said, Lord, why is my friend going through so much sickness? In one hospital, I'm talking about over the last 10 years, cancer, stage 4, amen, and had to go chemo and all this, and then he had the heart attack, Sister Francis, Prophetess Francis, his wife, passed away, and he went through deep, dark depression over that, and then just in the next year, Sister Pat, she was deeply in love. I don't know if y'all know how much, but he was deeply in love with Sister Pat. That's all he can talk about here. Amen. And God, I believe, gave me the answer. I said, why is she going through so much sickness? Why is she spending day after day, week after week in hospital and rehab? And this, don't be shocked. And I asked him, I got permission to say this morning. Praise God. And I've asked Sister Maddie if she would video this. Amen. Because he said, I want to see it. I said, okay. You give me permission. God showed me the reason he's going through so much sickness, not just for the grave, but all of us. Lots of things have happened to us, bad things, is because we allow depression to come in and the devil to attack us, and the devil pushes us down instead of rising above it to know, no, I'm not going to have this. See, depression is a killer.
Mm-hmm.
The doctor
will right.
take you.
Right.
Lots of sicknesses stem out and from people going through deep areas of depression.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. It affects your whole life.
Yes, it does.
Yes, ma'am.
This morning when I woke up at the gospel, first of all, I sleep every night with this to my chest. I hold this every night to my chest, and this is how I sleep. Every single night. I woke up this morning, and usually when God speaks to me, he speaks to me in the morning. So I woke up this morning and said, do not take a depression medicine. Take a depression medicine. Don't take it. Do not take your mood medicine. And I did not.
All right. That's just confirmation.
See?
That's
yeah.
When everything
was
wrong.
Amen.
All right. Amen. 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 All right. All right. Good for you. Well, look at you. Look at God. Yeah, look at God. You're gonna make it.
That's right.
And you're gonna make it good. You're gonna make it good. If you try to bring it, get that word out of you. All right. Okay, praise God. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Hallelujah. Bless his name. I looked for the word depression in the Bible, but I couldn't find it. But the word oppression is in the Bible. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. The Bible talks about oppression.
Yes, it does.
J-K-L-M-N-O. All right. Somebody say, thank the Lord. Praise God. Okay. There's a whole bunch talking about oppressed. Job 35:9, they make the oppressed cry. God said, I'm going to judge the oppressed. He's going to help them. Amen. Let not the oppressed return to shame. Psalm 73:21. It says about Jesus. This is Isaiah 53:7. You can write this down. Isaiah 53:7. He was oppressed and afflicted of man, but God was with him. Amen. Was Jesus oppressed? Was he feeling the pressure? Yes, he was. Praise God. Isaiah 58 and 6. This is something you and I are supposed to do. Let the oppressed go free. That's what we're doing this morning. Amen. Praise God. Acts 10, 38. I know what it says, but let's turn over there and read it all over. Everybody say Acts 10, 38. Praise God. I've got a little saying, and I got a all cap. It says, too blessed to be oppressed. And the brother that gave it to me, popped out a little bit soil, so I put it in the cleaner so I didn't have it. I would have wanted to have brought it this morning. Amen. Let's go to Acts 10:38. Praise God. Say, I'm too blessed to be stressed. Praise God. Too anointed to be disappointed. All right. I want to write it down. I'm too anointed to be disappointed. I'm too blessed to be stressed. Praise God. Okay, this is Acts 10:38. It says, this is Apostle Peter up preaching in Cornelius' house. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing what? Good. And healing how many? All healing that were what? Oppressed. There's that word again. Oppressed. Is it God's will to heal the oppressed?
Yes.
Yes, it is. Who puts oppression on people?
Satan.
Satan, the devil. It's Satan that does it. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but he has given us a spirit of power, love
and a sound mind.
God does not want his children oppressed. No more than we parents want our children down and out and oppressed.
Amen.
Amen. It did not come from God, and you got to realize that, and you got to fight it. I refuse to be oppressed. Amen. Praise God. I told my friend, Brother Brady, I said, Brother Brady, can you acknowledge what I'm saying is true? And he said, yes, sir, I can. He said, even before Prophet Francis passed away, he had other things, you know. His dad, I mean, y'all know his stepdad raised him, and told him when he was in the third or fourth grade, the teacher called the dad in and said, amen, your son is mentally retarded, and said he believed it. But he said, I've had to fight that thing all my life.
Amen.
Just because one teacher or one doctor gives you a bad report, there's no time you have to take it.
Amen. That's right. Yes.
That's what the word says.
Amen.
Did you believe this? Praise God. Well, I think I broke my mind. I'll hold it together. Thank the Lord. Praise God. Woo! Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. We're more than conquerors. We're more than knights.
Yes, we are.
We're more than conquerors. We're more than conquerors. Through Him, not in ourselves, but through Him that works on us.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Acts 10:38, say it again with me. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all, I love that word, all, healing all that were what?
Oppressed.
Of who? Of the devil. Who puts oppression on people?
The devil.
And you fight it with the word. Don't fight the devil and say, I've been a good little boy. I've been a good little girl. Devil, I'll be nice to you if you'll be nice to me. No. Wrong answer. You don't fight him. Tell him how good you are. You tell him what Jesus did and what Jesus said.
Yes.
Jesus said. The word said. Jesus fought the devil with the word of God. And that's
yes.
The only thing you can and I can fight with is with the Holy Ghost and the word of God.
Amen.
Preach Holy Ghost. How God anointed Jesus of baptized with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's power. The word of God is powerful. It's sharper than any two-edged sword.
Yes.
Some of us need to meditate just on that one scripture. The word of God is sharper than any two-edged sword.
Yes.
We don't deal much with swords. Amen. Very few of us have probably even seen a real, truthful sword. Amen. And I like the word make a little F out of the word sword and one the little four letters.
Word.
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 I love that. Amen. The word, take the sword. In the Old Testament, they had to use natural swords to fight the enemy with. But they went through the land conquering. And every time they were obedient to God, God caused Israel to win every battle. Every battle. But when they were drawn back in themselves, we don't know if God would get deliverance out of this situation or not. Blah, blah, blah. They would lose. You know, David won every battle he ever entered? As long as he was obedient. God fought his battles and God fought your battles if you stay obedient. As men are led by the Spirit of God, they are the
sons of God. Yes.
Hallelujah. We don't have much time left, saints. We got to fight and win every battle. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
I got to win every battle. I got you. There's not much time left for any of us. Time is drawing to a close.
Can I hear an amen?
Amen. Have God in honor of Jesus and Mary. I'm going to read it again. With the Holy Ghost and the power. Who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. And we're witnesses of all these things, which he did both in the land of the Jews and in Jerusalem, whom when they slew and hanged on the tree. But him God raised up the third day and showed him openly. Praise God. And look, drop on down to verse 44, still in the 10th chapter of Acts. While Peter yet spake these words, who fell on them? The Holy Ghost fell on all them which heard the word. Then you got to hear the word. And they of the circumcision, that's the Jews which believed, were astonished. Wow. As many came to Peter, he called that on the Gentiles also was poured out the gift of the Holy Ghost. So this is the first time the Gentiles received the baptism of the Holy Ghost as evidence of speaking in other tongues.
Yes.
For, because of that, verse 46, for they heard them speak with what? Tongues. And do what else? Magnify God. And then answer Peter, can any man forbid more that these should not be baptized which have received the Holy Ghost as well as them? Praise God. Wow. Woo. Hallelujah. We serve a mighty God.
Yes, we do.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We serve a mighty God. Hallelujah. Well, I tell you what, I'm just going to have to cut it off right here. Maybe we'll take it up again tonight. I don't know. We'll just see what the Holy Ghost says. Bless the Lord. Praise God. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers and wickedness in high places. Praise God. Bless the Lord. I read something stuck with me. It says, the devil, I'm not bragging on the devil, but I'm telling you what his attributes. How many know God patient, God? Very patient. Well, let me tell you something. The devil is very patient too. And he'll try to wear you out. He will try. I didn't say he'll do it. I said he'll try to wear you out. And I believe the devil studies us to see where can I knock them down at? Where are they weak? What area? And see, that's, amen. Like I heard Sister Joyce Meyer say, if you've got trouble with your anger, you don't need to study on prosperity. You need to look up some scriptures on anger. Amen. Praise God. Whatever area you're having trouble with the devil and your flesh with, amen, that's where you need to dig out the word, the scriptures, and meditate on them, and talk and speak and talk and meditate on them. Let's stand before you start again. Praise the Lord. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. This is a scripture I quote an awful lot. Is I am more than a conqueror. I'm more than a Nike. I'm more than a Nike. I'm more than a conqueror. I'm more than a conqueror. I'm not just a conqueror. I'm more than a conqueror. That's in the 8th chapter of Romans. Amen?
Amen.
Say, I'm more than a conqueror.
I'm more than a conqueror.
Praise God. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Wow. God's an awesome God. Hallelujah. He brought me out of my mess so many times. How many know we all have mess?
Yes, we do.
Sometimes, brother, we all have mess. Amen. Jerry Skelton is not perfect in himself, but the Jesus in me, he's perfect.
Amen.
The Jesus in you is perfect. Just turn him loose. Turn him loose. Praise God. Bless the Lord. How many are saved and you know you're saved? If the trumpet were to sound, you go to heaven. There's no doubt in your mind. All right, good. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Praise God. Praise God. I hope you'll put that devil on the run. Quote so many scriptures, he can't stay close to you. He can't stay up on your shoulder talking in your ear. Amen? Resist him with the word. Fight him with the word. Whew. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord. Praise God. Sister loves two sons. Amen. I just want to hug y'all.
Amen.
Praise God. Thank y'all so much for coming. Praise God. They told me the homegoing service of the city. They said, we're going to be there. Bless you.
Amen.
All right. Write it down. I hope you wrote your scripture down. Don't take it lightly. fight that devil. Don't slip over the area of depression. Don't get in there. You find yourself falling into depression, start rebuking it mindlessly. Okay, y'all dismiss. I love y'all. I want to see everyone tonight. Come back tonight, everyone. We're going to have a...